Recently, my family was lucky enough to have a trip planned to Disney World to see the new Star Wars land, but unluckily, we had to cancel it because someone got sick, and by someone, I mean the Earth. But if James can't go to Disney World, then James is gonna bring Disney World to us. Trips to theme parks are incredibly fun, especially when you're not the one paying for them. Thank you, Olaf. The spoopy drop towers, meticulously immersive atmospheres, the loop-de-loop and poles, and your shoes are looking good. Theme parks offer us seemingly infinite ways to have fun, wrapped up in actually infinite wait times. I'm gonna die in this mask, dude. The long lines at bathrooms, rides, and turkey leg stands, and just the general time between the action offer us opportunities to connect. Opportunities that I want to explore with you. No, not you. You. Because they make theme parks so much more special. So, let's take a step back in time and explore.
Well, that was dramatic.
One of my first memories is going on a weekend trip to Hershey Park with my cousins and my sisters and the rest of my family. We didn't just go as like little babies. And you know, I was just old enough to not be a ball of duh anymore. So it was my first chance to really contribute to the group. And out of all the things that I could remember from that trip, the games, the rides, the shows, the candy, the only thing I remember is vigorously dancing to I Want Candy with my cousins and older sister in the hotel room one night. Hershey Park was and is awesome. I've went back there more than a few times in my life, but Hershey Park for me is the side dish, the mashed potatoes, if you will. Now, as you can see, I love mashed potatoes, maybe a little too much, but they serve to help me appreciate the main course, the ribeye, the chicken cutlets, the honey-baked hammock. I'm losing the analogy here. The theme park is the side dish. My family is the main dish. That sounds fun. The theme park served as a reason for my family to get together and a way for us to have fun and a special atmosphere where anyone can enjoy anybody's company. And somewhere in that mix, you make bonds and memories. And apparently that's what was important to me. Hershey and the attractions are amazing, especially as like a 5-year-old. But what really meant something to me was finding friends in my family and finally being part of the group. That special atmosphere that I mentioned back there deserves to be explored a bit more. Something I've always noticed about trips to theme parks is the chaotic energy it pulls out of the adults in my life. My family's never been boring or mellow, but we've never been people to break out into song and dance for the fun of it either. So, when I was 8 years old and I saw my dad, who up until this point I didn't think knew what dancing was, hit a perfect can-can off a diving board into a pool of slime in front of hundreds of people at Nickelodeon Studios, I almost added another patty to my Krabby Patty underwear. I think that chaotic energy probably derives from the freedom of being around complete strangers who you'll never see again, having a bunch of fun and new experiences at your beck and call, as well as escaping the constant stressors of day-to-day adult life that can kind of choke your personality right out of you. Or maybe they just pump microdoses of LSD into the air, because none of those reasons explains why my Nana, who is 4'10" and vertically challenged, popped off on a giant drunk man at the Epcot Wine Festival for accidentally knocking the third slice of baklava out of her incredibly overweight grandson's hands. When you finally get your license, though, theme parks take on a whole new life of their own. No more following your parents around in tow, no more setting schedules for what rides you need to hit when, and no more not being able to buy your 6th corn dog. It's just you, your boys, and the rides, and the $85 ticket to enter. But if you had just bought a can of Coke at the gas station like your boys, the ticket to entry would have been $6 with the coupon on the back, so you'll remember that for next time, unless you got talked into buying a $150 season pass. I don't know if you know, but $150 for the whole season is less than 2 1-day passes.
That's what they told me.
And that's such a good deal. Until you realize that there's no way you're gonna make the 110-minute drive, even somewhat consistently. But none of that matters because you're in the park with your boys. Maybe you stop at the food court when you get in, get a couple corn dogs to start the day, grab a can of Coke because it's hot outside, and oh, the coupon for the $6 entry is on the back of the fucking— But when you get off your first ride at 5 p.m, you won't even be thinking about the money anymore, because how could you think of anything but, if I had done even a smidgen of planning like my parents had my whole life, going to the only amusement park in the most overpopulated state in this fucking country, I would have gotten more than 2 rides this entire day. But even if you paid too much money, drove too far, and got on 2 rides all day, you still had a blast, because as young adults, you rode the air gondolas all day and pointed out what looked like cock and balls
with your boys.
Also, at this point in life, boy might be meeting Grill for the first time, and theme parks are a dope place for early adventures and memories in a relationship. There's so much to do, so much to see, they'll never realize you lack personality. Something we've mentioned a lot so far is memories, and memories are an integral part of the foundation of any strong relationship, bond, or friendship, and it just so happens theme parks are chock full of opportunities to make them. Observing all the crazy Karens out in the wild, getting to ride Splash Mountain 3 times in a row, breaking down on a roller coaster, walking into a bathroom and seeing a full-grown man at the urinal drop his pants and drawers fully to the ground. These are all opportunities to make memories, and in 2 years when they're on the verge of dumping you, you can both look back together on the time you went to Six Flags and you bought them a very overpriced sandwich just so they could pick apart the bread and throw it to the birds, and everything will calm down, you'll have a laugh together, and they'll still have to break your fucking heart because you're a very clingy and sad person. Now, when you get a license or turn 18, you start to feel like an adult, but you're not truly an adult until you smuggle handles of alcohol into your two-person Disney suite that you may have 5 people staying in. Tipsy theme parks with the boys is unmatched. Literally everything can be a possible punchline or a future inside joke. Usually you say you're gonna save the drinking for nighttime because you're in a family atmosphere. You don't want to disrupt that. And then one of your more chaotic friends takes like 6 shots at 9 a.m. and threatens to revoke your gamer card if you don't follow suit, and then, you know, just the ferry ride between parks becomes like the funniest fucking thing that's ever existed. But the fun doesn't stop at the tipsy rides because you're finally old enough to head to the downtown areas of the park after dark, and when you get there, you'll see a lot more drunk people being mesmerized by a beautiful man playing the didgeridoo, and if you're lucky enough like we were, he'll flick a guitar pick off stage and it'll land right on your sticky, sweaty forehead like some magical Mickey Mouse musical moment. Places like Disneyland or World, Harry Potter World, Universal Studios, hell, even Six Flags are magical. The rides are life experiences in and of themselves. The immersion they create is incredible. But the true magic lies in between all the attractions. It lies in the memories you make, the one-of-a-kind experiences you have, the incredible amount of jokes, and the bonds you form with friends, family, and even strangers. Thank you very much for watching till the end of my video. This idea came to me at a time where I thought I couldn't think of an idea to save my life, and it just hit different. The script took me a long time to get together because theme parks have been a huge part of my life and I wanted to do them justice, and I hope I have. Thank you so much for your incredible patience in between these videos. Hopefully this next one about a certain mischievous raccoon will not take 1 month, but for all the time in between these big videos that take me far too long, subscribe to the second channel for Twitch compilations. Go over to Twitch and follow me over there. Please follow me on Twitter. I fucking love Twitter and all the memeing we all do with each other. It is so much fun. And get in the Discord too. We do a bunch of fun stuff over there, and there's a whole bunch of meta memes about the channel already forming in there. But with all that said, do everything everybody else tells you to do at the end of their videos to my video, and I'll see you in the next one. Farewell.